WBAL TV 11 News in Baltimore. This is a special report.
Good afternoon, everyone. I'm Lisa Robinson. The Aberdeen Police Department is about to address the abduction of Violet Ripken, the mother of Orioles Hall of Famer Cal Ripken Jr. Let's listen in.
Ready?
Go ahead.
Okay. The Aberdeen Police Department received a call from the Baltimore County Police Department last night at about 8:30 p.m., at which time county police had received a call about a suspicious vehicle in the Ebenezer Road area of the county, and the information that was obtained at that time led to the investigation of Miss Ripken's disappearance. At about 6:15 this morning, Mrs. Ripken was located unharmed in her vehicle in close proximity to her residence. At that time, she was assessed by local paramedics from the Aberdeen Fire Department, where she was not found to be injured, and at this time, she is resting with her family. Between 7 and 8 a.m. Tuesday morning, we believe a male subject approached Miss Ripken at her residence, produced a handgun, and forced Miss Ripken into her vehicle, at which time he fled the area. After he fled the area, we believe that he drove throughout central Maryland, and at this time we are not sure what locations he was at, what time he was driving, in what counties, and that is still under investigation at this time. Police are still looking for a white male, late 30s to early 40s, with a tall, thin build. He was last seen wearing a light colored shirt, camo pants, and eyeglasses. We believe the male is still armed with the handgun and should be considered dangerous. This investigation was handled by the Aberdeen Police Department with assistance from the FBI, the Harford County Sheriff's Office, the Maryland State Police, and the Baltimore County Police. We all worked together and collaborated in this investigation. That is the facts that most know already, so if you have any questions, I'll be glad to answer.
What's the suspect's motive? What's the motive?
Was she in the car the entire time? She was missing for about 24 hours or so, or unaccounted for. And can you describe what state, when you did find her, was she tied up? Was she gagged? What can you tell us?
What I can tell you right now, that if her state, of course, she was upset when we found her. How we found her and what she was wearing and whether she was bound at the time that we put her out of the car, we are not releasing at this time. The investigators are still talking to her and witnesses to determine exactly what happened and where it happened.
Was her credit card used, ATM card? What was the motive?
Motive is unknown at this time. Investigators are still out there. This case is still brand new. We are really beginning the investigation. We have several investigators from several agencies out there talking to as many witnesses as we can. Since we've put the information out, we've gotten several calls from throughout the area, and each one of these calls are being interviewed. Each one of these callers are being interviewed, and their information is being investigated.
Mrs. Ripken doesn't believe this guy knew who she was. She's saying that he didn't recognize the Ironburg stuff. Is there anything? Do you think this was a Ripken kidnapping, or is this just some random crime? What do you think at this point?
Right now, we can't speak of what the motive is. We are still looking at this investigation. We are looking at every witness, every clue. For us to say or speculate on a motive would be unfair and just wouldn't be true.
Chief, what if any contact was there between the kidnapper and the Ripken family? Any kind of ransom demand, anything like that?
And if you can look straight ahead as you answer.
Yeah, at this time we don't know what, if any, relationship there was between the perpetrator of this crime and Ripken family.
Was there a ransom demand? Demand for money?
At this time, I can say we know of no ransom demand.
Did he get your ATM?
One question was: which car was he driving around in? Was it her car or was it another vehicle? Because it's unclear from the state and from the news release.
He was driving her vehicle, which was a silver Lincoln Continental. I believe it was a 1998. He was driving her vehicle. She was taken from her residence in her vehicle, and she was located back at her residence in her vehicle.
Was she in the trunk at the time?
All right, thank you very much. That is all we can talk about right now. As soon as we know anything else, and like I said, this thing is moving very quickly, and we are interviewing people as we are right here. There's people being interviewed right now. As soon as we know something, we will let you know, and any pertinent information we will get after the media as soon as possible.
Was it a citizen's tip? Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Okay, again, you've been listening in to the Aberdeen Police Department about the abduction of Violet Ripken, who we're told is now at home, resting safely. She's been checked out by paramedics and was found upset visibly, of course, but unharmed. Again, she was abducted around 7 or 8 o'clock yesterday morning from her home by a man who was armed with a gun. That man, we're told, who then put her in her car and drove her around central Maryland. Police are not saying what areas they stopped in and where exactly they went. They say they're still looking at that. As a matter of fact, they're going back over phone calls that they may have gotten from different jurisdictions. And let's go out now to Jane Miller, who has been following this story. Jane, what can you tell us? What else have you learned at this news conference?
Well, I can tell you that our sources are telling us that Vi Ripken was indeed tied up with duct tape the entire through this entire episode, and that when she was found this morning at 6:15, not a long distance from her house, but close to her house, she was still tied up in the car. And it's our understanding from sources that it was a passerby who discovered that. Let's go back to when this story really kind of came to light, which was about 8:15, 8:30 last night. That's the call that the chief mentioned that the Aberdeen Police Department got from the Baltimore County Police Department. I can fill in some of the blanks about that. Again, according to sources, there was an individual who was at that intersection, and that intersection is at Ebenezer Road and Route 40, not far from the White Marsh Mall in that area. And if anybody's familiar with that, it's a very busy intersection. It's got convenience stores on the intersection, gas stations, there's a diner there, a 24-hour diner, so there's a lot going on that intersection. Someone noticed a car and called Baltimore County Police and said that he noticed an older woman that appeared to be tied up in the car and obviously thought it was suspicious and called 911. Baltimore County ran the tag and then turned it over to Aberdeen because obviously the address on the tag would come back to Aberdeen. Aberdeen Police recognized who this was, which was Vi Ripken, and that's at that point the investigation began. It wasn't until early this morning, though, that they reported her missing. That's one of the blanks that we're still trying to fill in. And it was about the time that we confirmed she was missing that indeed she was found, located, unharmed, still in that vehicle. So the way the scenario plays out is someone approaches her yesterday morning while she's in her garage doing some chores, holds a gun to her, forces her in the car, drives her all over the state, or at least all over central Maryland. We have other folks that have told us that he did not harm her. He took care of her. He offered her cigarettes. He made sure she got something to eat. No demand for ransom. You heard the chief say that. We don't know if her credit cards were used. That's one part of the investigation. And then ultimately, almost 24 hours later, drove back to the same neighborhood where she lives here in Aberdeen, left the car, left her in it, and fled. There are a lot of questions that still need answers in this investigation. It is being treated as a kidnapping. It does involve a number of different agencies. The good news is that Vi Ripken is apparently okay.
Jane, let me ask you this. I think we're trying to get to it, but you said they're not sure about the ransom. This is still a very active case, and they're not quite sure about the relationship between the Ripken family, that this abductor knew her relationship. And that's still up in the air?
Sure. And, you know, obviously in Aberdeen, everybody knows the Ripkens. They know exactly where the Ripkens live. This is a small town, and they live in a neighborhood just a little bit outside of town. Typical suburban neighborhood, older suburban neighborhood. There are wooded areas around it. And obviously what it appears is that the suspect either arrived in that neighborhood in a car and left it to take her car and her in it, or arrived on foot from some other place, took her, kidnapped her, drove her around and came back, left the car, and then fled on foot. You heard a description of a suspect. And there are many questions that are going to be asked over the next hours as this investigation unfolds, but clearly the motive is one of the most one of the big mysteries here.
All right, thank you, Jane, live in Aberdeen. We'll check back with you tonight at 5 and 6. And let me just give that description of the man that they are still looking for again. They say they're looking for a white male in his late 30s to early 40s who was last seen wearing a light colored shirt, camouflage pants, and eyeglasses.